later in the month. Thank you both.
Time now is 8:56. This week's edition of The Apprentice had a culinary theme. The two teams were sent to Edinburgh to try and run a stall selling street food.
The losing team, though, opted to sell corned beef meatballs at sky-high prices to football fans.
Before we speak to the fired candidate, here's the moment Lord Sugar chose who to eject.
Whose idea was it to go to the football? Let's talk about the football location first.
To be honest, I championed that.
On what basis?
Football. You know, I go to football games, it's £6 a burger. I thought that...
£6 a burger? Where do you go? Chelsea? Had you gone to the football ground and sold it for £2.50 a portion, you might have sold hundreds of portions. You might have made some more money. Katie, I'm afraid to say that having been in this position the third time, I'm not convinced. And so, Katie, you're fired.
Oh, Katie. She's here with us now. Very good morning to you.
Good morning.
Have you watched that before? Have you seen it back?
No, that's... Well, obviously, I watched it last night.
But, yeah. Was it a bit weird?
It was pretty much how I remember it, yes. Pretty accurate, yes.
Because sometimes people say, you know, they were slightly misrepresented or we didn't get a true sense of, you know, what happened. Do you think it was kind of as it was?
And... Yeah, I mean, obviously, there's a lot of hours that go into an one-hour show, but, you know, I think it gets the main part of the storyline and the reason why the final people are in the boardroom.
Do you think it was fair, then, that it was you that was chosen?
I think that based on this task alone, yeah, for sure. You know, I really did push
going
really
to the
football ground.
You really went for the
ground.
Football? That was the choice. You had choices of where to pitch your stall and you really went for the football.
Yeah, but I mean, you know, I just think, you know, maybe I could have gone a bit further, but, you know, I think, you know, Lord Sugar's made his mind up, so, you know, I don't think he often regrets it.
Yeah, and you, I mean, what I guess you made a decision, did you, that you wanted to stick your neck out to do something rather than be, you know, Lord Sugar always says the worst thing is to be one of those wallflowers who he hasn't heard from. So you thought, you know, I will take the responsibility. And I think you literally said, as the decision was being made, you know, blame me if this goes wrong.
I think that's a deadly move on The Apprentice, though. So, you know, I don't know what I was thinking. But, yeah, you know, I made some really risky moves throughout the whole 6 weeks I was on the show. You know, last week we did the groove train and that was my idea. And, you know, but the biggest risks in business and in The Apprentice, you know, can either pay off, making you look like the biggest genius or the biggest fool. And I suppose this time I'm sat here as the biggest fool, so.
Oh, let's have a look at, though, when you were taking, as you honestly say, a responsibility for what happened.
But if I was setting up a business, I wouldn't go to football. End of. But if we don't get footfall tomorrow, we've lost.
Spotting a chance to feed football fans, research and development manager Katie.
If we know that we're going to have people, I know that we're going to sell. You'd be a fool not to go for football.
I'm against it. Football fan, cold day. I'm going to get a burger and a beer.
I just think we can sell anything when you've got that many people walking past you.
Even if we don't sell to a bigger percentage as you would.
You've convinced me. Take the product out of it. If we've got 40,000 people at the game tomorrow, we're going to sell 200.
I'm happy for that to fall on my head if the football's like a bad idea. No, I've pushed it.
Makes sense.
There we go. There was that fateful moment.
Oh, dear.
What's Stephen like?
Oh, Stephen's great. He's quite Machiavellian, I think that's fair to say. I think I've realised that more looking back on it than when I was there. He's very positive to be around. You know, I think he looks slightly like Inspector Gadget. So
he does
like
those big bug eye thing, doesn't he?
Does, yeah.
Widens the eyes.
But he's great fun to be around. Really positive, which can, you know, can be good, and sometimes it can be too much. But
is it interesting being? Because you were in the boardroom quite a few times, weren't you? Actually,
it's my second home, along with the calf. You know.
Is it interesting being in there because people suddenly tend to turn on other people that perhaps they have been friends with before?
Yeah, it's a really stressful environment to be in because you're never like in that situation in business. And you know, I work in politics and I'm used to stressful situations, but nothing like that. You feel like you're fighting for your life rather than fighting to stay in, you know, in The Apprentice. Mm.
Do you get a sense, and when you've been in the boardroom as you have a few times, do you get a sense whether Alan Sugar kind of likes you? I mean, are you sitting there thinking, do you know what, I'm not sure if he gets, you know, a sense of whether he gets what you have to offer?
I think it really comes down to whether he saves you. And, you know, he actually kind of saved me three times because I was in the bottom three twice and got saved. And I nearly went into the boardroom in week two until he sort of said, no, come on, Jane, you've got to make the right decision. But, you know, ultimately, he doesn't like me that much because I'm not his business partner and he hasn't given me £250,000. So, you know, I could defend my actions to the end of the earth, but I'm sat here.
So what are you doing now? You've got your own, because everybody who's gone in this year has all got their own business, haven't
that's
they?
That's right. Yeah. No, that's not true. You were going in there to pitch for.
Right, okay, but you've got an idea.
Yeah, no, at the moment I'm a director at an organisation called Neil Stewart Associates, which is a public policy publisher. Mm. And I've always been a political researcher, so that's my background. So back to the day job now for me.
I'm intrigued now. So when people have seen you on The Apprentice and they see you in your day job now.
Yeah.
Apprentice has a lot of viewers, yeah. And people make judgments about you. I mean, they do, don't they?
Yeah, you know, I'm going straight from here to a conference at the Lowry on children's centres, and, you know, people are going to go, oh, well, hang on a minute, you know, but, you know, that's part of the fun of it.
Because they probably think they know you quite well already, do they? They've sort of made a decision about what you're like.
Well, they see a version of you, you know, they see, I suppose, the professional and the goofy side. You know, obviously I was running around Edinburgh on last night's episode in a pizza costume, selling meatballs, which is a strange thing to do, I suppose.
Just quickly, who would you tip to go through to the final couple?
I would love Gabrielle too. She's intelligent, she's creative, and she's nice. So what more can you ask?
I'm not sure that works.
Thank you very much for coming in for us this morning.
Thank you very much.
Good to meet you, thank you. The Apprentice is on every Wednesday.